Welcome to our workshop on mouse genotyping. Today, we'll talk about mice, their genes, and how we find out what genes they have. You and I, we are all made up of trillions of cells. Inside each of our cells are molecules called DNA, short for deoxyribonucleic acid. These molecules are made up of atoms stuck together in the shape of a ladder that is turned and twisted many times, called a double helix. DNA is the genetic code that tells our cells what to do. Basically, DNA is what makes us the way we are. Our DNA has over 20,000 genes. DNA is present in all living things, not just us, like animals, plants, and even insects. As scientists, sometimes we wonder, what does each gene do? In order to find out, many scientists use what we call transgenic mice. We can delete the gene we are interested in mice and see what happens. To do this, we can use special methods to delete the gene in mouse cells or embryos, and then put them into a female mouse, and this mouse will then give birth to some baby mice that have the gene deleted. To check which mice have the gene deleted, we do a test called genotyping. To do genotyping, first, we have to take some cell samples from mice. In order to find out their genes, we need the DNA. In order to get the DNA from inside the cells, we have to break up the cells. This is called DNA extraction. First, we add a liquid that has chemicals, which helps break down the cells to release the DNA. We have to add this to all of our samples. Next, we heat up the samples to 95 degrees to help break up the cells and release the DNA. After 1 hour, we take out the samples. Careful, it's hot! Next, we spin the samples very fast in a machine called a centrifuge to collect any condensation on the sides of the tubes. Here, we're putting the samples inside the centrifuge. All the samples are now inside the centrifuge. Now let's close it up and get it started. Next, we add another chemical to stop the reaction and stabilize the DNA. The DNA is now ready for the next step. To find out if the DNA from our mouse has the gene of interest, for example, gene X depicted in blue, we will perform PCR, or polymerase chain reaction. What this does is a special molecule that is specific to gene X, called primers, will bind to the DNA and make many copies of gene X. But if we knock out the gene, then the primers can no longer bind and make copies of this gene. So to do PCR, we will take some of the DNA and mix it with primers. Can you see the mixture inside the tubes? To make sure all the samples and all the liquids are at the bottom of the tubes, we will use a centrifuge, a smaller one than the one we used earlier, to make sure all the liquids are at the bottom. Then we put the samples into a machine called a thermocycler. This sets the temperature for PCR to happen. after we run PCR, how do we know which samples have copies and which ones don't? To find out, we can perform gel electrophoresis. We can run our samples in a gel and apply an electric current. Since DNA is negatively charged, it's attracted towards the positive electrode. The gel also separates the DNA by size, since smaller pieces can move faster through the gel than longer pieces. To do this, first we must make the gel. This is sort of like making Jell-O at home. We have to weigh out some of the agarose powder, which makes up the gel. We then put the powder in a flask and we add some liquid for it to dissolve in. To dissolve the powder, we heat it up using a microwave, just like your microwave at home. While the microwave is going, we can set up the tray to mold the gel, similar to making Jell-O at home. The green pieces here are combs to help us shape the wells for us to put our sample into. The microwave timer is up. Can you still see the powder? If not, perfect. Since it is super hot, we have to cool it down a little bit by swirling it on ice. Now we can add a dye that binds the DNA and lights up when we shine UV light on it so that we can see the DNA bands later. Swirl and swirl to mix in the dye. And now we are ready to pour into the mold, and we have to wait for it to set and harden. After 15 to 20 minutes, the gel is now hardened, and we can set it up for gel electrophoresis. First, we take out the combs that made the wells for us to add the samples. Next, we put it into a tank with electrodes and liquid that can conduct the electric current. Now to add our samples. Careful not to poke through the gel. After adding all the samples, we are ready to run. And all we have to do now is connect the tank to the machine, and you can see here there are the negative and the positive electrodes. And off we go! We can run the gel for 45 minutes to 1.5 hours. Here is the gel after finishing. To see the dye, we need to apply UV light. We will do this using this transilluminator. First, put your gel into the machine. Now, just turn on the light, and we can see our DNA band. In the first lane, we have the ladder. This gives us an idea of the sizes of our samples. Here, highlighted in the yellow boxes, are samples of control mice that we know have gene X. Next to it, we see some samples that have the same band. These are mice that have gene X. And on the left, there are lanes without any bands. This shows that these mice don't have gene X. Now we know which mice don't have the gene and which mice do. This means that we can do tests on these mice to see what happens when gene X is gone. This will help us figure out what gene X does. Thank you so much for joining us today. We hope you learned something new, and please feel free to contact us if you have any questions.